Hi everyone, it's Tiara. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be doing a review, swatch and tutorial on the Ferrarosa Beauty Perlux eyeshadows. So they actually contacted me and sent these over for me to try. However, I would just like to let you guys know that even though that these were sent to me, I was not paid to say good things about them. This video I'm doing out of my own free will and my opinions are my own and they are not swayed by the fact that they sent me stuff. So just keeping it real with you guys because I don't want you guys to think that, you know, just because I get sent stuff, I am compelled to say good things about it. It doesn't work that way on my channel. So yeah. Anyway, I've already tried these eyeshadows and so I'm gonna give you my thoughts on them. I will do live swatches and also inserts for you guys, and also we'll do a little short tutorial on how I use these eyeshadows. Yeah, so let's dive right in. First up, this is how the packaging looks like. I was sent this magnetic palette along with four of their single eyeshadows. The packaging is so pretty. It's this really nice blush pink box with rose gold font and foiling. However, the thing that I have a gripe with this is that it's easily dirty, as you can see. I've already dirtied it right here. But moving on, I received these four eyeshadows that I will get into in a little bit. I just wanted to share with you guys a couple, one thing that I was very impressed by, and it's the fact that these eyeshadows, even though they are imported and distributed by her brand Ferrarosa, who is a Malaysian makeup artist. You can go and follow her on Instagram. Her makeup looks gorgeous. Yeah, it's imported by her company and distributed by her company, of course. However, they are actually made in Korea, which really lit my eyes just lit up. I was like, oh, it's made in Korea. Because, you know, Korean makeup products and skincare products are known to be like really good and they rarely disappoint me, at least the ones that I've tried. So I was really impressed by that. So I'm referring to my screen right here where I have like the website up. And these are actually called the Perlux eyeshadows. And according to Ferrarosa, I quote her because this is available on her website. She says that the most pigmented eyeshadows ever. The texture is velvety and super blendable. I want to make only the best formula because I am very fussy about eyeshadows. And you can actually see that because she, you know, of her eyeshadow looks and the fact that she does makeup. So she knows her stuff. From what I'm reading on the website, these eyeshadows retail for in a bundle of 5, and this bundle costs 225 ringgit, which is about approximately 75 Singapore dollars for 5 eyeshadows, which is roughly around $15 per eyeshadow pen. Generally, I think that's, I guess it's an okay amount to pay for an eyeshadow, like a single eyeshadow, because if I'm not wrong, if you purchase from Makeup Geek and you do the conversion, the prices are around like $10 Singapore, inclusive of shipping and all that. So it's a bit higher in my opinion, like the price is slightly higher than what I would pay for say Makeup Geek or maybe ColourPop single eyeshadows. But they are not overly expensive, say like for example MAC single eyeshadows. When you buy the bundle of 5, it doesn't come with this magnetic thing, I think. You have to purchase a magnetic palette on a separate website or on your own accord. So they only sell this in like bundles of 5 and in singles. They don't come in like a compact kind of like packaging. They have different like themes of colors of eyeshadows. So they're, for example, the one I'm looking at is like raspberry, and then there's other themes. So you have to choose like which bundle you think would suit your eyeshadow like preference, I guess. So here are the four eyeshadows that I received from Ferrarosa Beauty. The first one is called Red Velvet, and this is like a satin burgundy shade, and it's a very fall kind of color. So this is what it looks like. When I swirl my finger into the pan, there is not much fallout. It doesn't feel crumbly. It actually feels very smooth. The texture is kind of like hard-ish, but the color payoff is actually not bad when I swirl it with my fingers. I've actually done an Instagram story where I showed you like the swatches. Honestly, when I first swatched it, it wasn't very impressed. I was impressed by it, but I expected it to be more pigmented than it really is. So I'm just going to show you what I mean. So this is the shade Red Velvet. Gorgeous color. Yeah, so this is what Red Velvet looks like. It's a very nice burgundy shade. As you can see, the color payoff is actually not bad. I'm not saying that it's bad, it's just that I kind of was expecting it to be more creamy and more like solid. Like I was expecting the swatch to be more solid than it is. But it's not bad because it doesn't crumble and it's not chalky at all. It's packed with pigment, but it's just not translating as much as when I use my fingers to swatch it. But it's not a really big, it's not a big problem, at least to me. That's just my initial thought of these eyeshadows. And then I'm gonna swatch the next shade, and this is also like a satin glitter shade, and it's called Eclair. My god, I use this all over my lids, and for a brief moment I felt like Niloufar with her like signature bronze eyeshadow, and also I felt like the Princess of Johor on her wedding day with the gold, the bronze eyeshadow. It is so gorgeous, and I'm gonna tell you why. Again, the texture for this, I feel that it's much smoother and more buttery than Red Velvet. It swatches similarly, but I feel that I like this texture more. And the reason why I love this eyeshadow shade so much is that it's a very rich satin bronze color, but there are flecks of gold glitter, very very fine glitter. No, there's flecks of very very fine gold glitter, and when you like turn your eyes, when you put it on your eyelids and you just like move your head to like where the light is, right, it actually catches the flecks of glitter and it makes the eyeshadow look so good, so multi-dimensional. I love this shade. I don't know if the camera will do it justice. I hope it will, because I have not done the inserts yet, but I've put this all over my lids and I had a Niloufar / Princess of Johor moment. I'm not even kidding. So the next two shades are actually matte shades. The first one is Raspberry, and again this is a nice burgundy / it's like Red Velvet but the matte version, and it has a little bit more purple in it. So again, the texture is very smooth and buttery. It's more like, not say chalky, but it has a bit more of like a chalky feel as compared to the satins, but it's not bad. This is what it looks like, and I think in the swatches you can actually see what I mean by a bit of the chalkiness that's happening. But again, nothing too drastic or nothing too terrible. Again, I do have like hair on my arm, so maybe that's the reason why. And the last shade I have is the shade Tiramisu, which is a very nice warm chocolate brown. I've used this on my crease and I love the color. It's just gorgeous. So this is what it looks like. And again, the texture is slightly more chalky than the satin shades, but nothing very very bad because the color is still, you know, it's still translating. So overall, I'm okay with the pigmentation of these eyeshadows. I expected them to be more buttery, more solid, but just like, I mean, I remember swatching my Makeup Geek eyeshadows for the very first time and they don't necessarily come off as like very solid swatches, but when you put them on the eye, you get like it works, like, you know, it really really works. Alright, so now I'm gonna scoot you guys closer to see how these eyeshadows perform on the eyelids. I'm gonna be doing like a burgundy kind of look because I'm feeling the Red Velvet shade that I swatched earlier on, and yeah, let's just get into the tutorial. Now that we are slightly closer and you can see up my face and my eyes, I'm gonna do the eyeshadow now. So because the colors that I was sent, I didn't get like a cream shade, so I'm just gonna quickly set my brow bone and my crease area with a matte cream eyeshadow. Alright, so the first shade that I'm going to go in with is the shade Tiramisu, and it's this very nice brown shade, and I'm going in with a 217 blending brush, or you can use any blending brush that you want. I'm just going to do a close-up of this, but When you dip your brush inside, there is kickback. So be sure to tap off the excess before you apply it onto your eyelids. These eyeshadows are actually quite pigmented, so do be careful when you like start to apply them on your eyelids, because you don't want it to suddenly like, then you like get a shot of your life, that kind of drama, you know. So I'm just gonna place this on my crease just to buff it in, or like just to act as a transition shade. As you can see, despite like it not giving a solid swatch and having kickback, the color actually translates very nicely when you buff it into the crease. The next color I'm going to take is the shade Raspberry, which is the matte burgundy shade. Again, I'm just using the same brush right here and I'm just dusting it off a little bit, tapping a bit at the tip of my brush. Again, this also has a little bit of kickback, but nothing too terrible. These eyeshadows also blend very, very well. They just melt into each other, if that makes sense. Alright, so that's my crease work done. I'm pretty satisfied with that, but I might go in to intensify it. But now I'm going to work on my lid shade, and I'm going to be using the shade Red Velvet. Oops, terbalik. I'm going to be using the shade Red Velvet. I'm going to do this two ways. The first way is I'm going to use my fingers, and the second one is I'm going to wet a brush and pack it onto my eyelids. I used the shade Eclair the other day, and I used my fingers, and I felt that it stuck to my fingers more than it did to my eyelids, which was a bit irritating. So what I did was I actually spritzed my brush with a fixing spray or makeup spray, and that deposited a bit more color onto my eyelids. I've not tried this shade yet on my eyelids, so I don't know how it's gonna perform. I think that this shade is a bit hard, like the color is, I have to swirl a bit. Same thing, it just sticks onto my finger, but again the reflex on this is so pretty. I'm gonna take my blending brush and just blend everything out. I'm gonna take my brush and I'm gonna spray some setting spray. So I already spritz my brush. Okay, much better. Spritz your brush and then dip it into the eyeshadow. I'm gonna blend it out. And then I'm gonna take the shade Raspberry again, and I'm going to buff it into my crease just to define it and like smoke it out even more. Okay, so I'm gonna finish out this eye and put liner and mascara and everything. Alright, so I put on some lipstick, some eyeliner, lashes, and of course some glitter, and this is the finished look. So that was a very simple look that I conjured up using the four eyeshadows from Fera Rosa Beauty, and I have to say that I really like how the eyeshadow look turned out. Now that we are done with the swatches and the tutorial using the Fera Rosa Beauty eyeshadows, I'm gonna share with you guys my final thoughts on them. First and foremost, I think that the price point is a little bit steep for like a shade of 5 eyeshadows, and when you break it down per pen, it's about 15 bucks Singapore dollars, which is, to me, it's a little bit expensive considering the fact that I could have, or I have purchased single eyeshadows that are much cheaper than that. However, that being said, it is not the most expensive single eyeshadow. Like for example, MAC eyeshadows are running at 22 Singapore dollars per pen, and they are even more higher end, Makeup Forever, that's like really expensive, like 30 plus per pen. So the price is not super steep, but it's not the most like affordable and worth it, you know, eyeshadow pen that is available for you to purchase. So that's, I'm just gonna put that aside, the price point. Quality wise, I find that they are very mediocre. They are actually not, they're not as like fantastic as I thought that they would be, but they actually perform like relatively well on my eyelids, and I'm really happy with how the eyeshadows look. However, I do have to say that some of the eyeshadows are kind of dry. Like for example, the one that I use all over my eyelids, which is Red Velvet, I found that the texture is a little bit dry and it refused to stick onto my eyelids for some reason. So if you have these eyeshadows and you experience the same problem, or if you're intending to purchase these eyeshadows, I highly recommend using a flat brush. spritz it with a little bit of makeup setting spray or like eye drops or water even, that's possible to pick up the color and pack it onto your eyelids, because I feel that it gives a better pigment and a better color payoff. And this is for the satin shades. But for the matte shades, even though like they swatch kind of like meh-ish, when you use a brush and buff it into your crease, it actually blends very, very well and it blends very fast. It doesn't get muddy at all. So I think the matte shades, I like the matte shades because of that lah. It's just very easy for me to blend and it picks up the right amount of product on my brush before I transfer it and blend it onto my eyes. Out of all the four shades that I have, Red Velvet, Tiramisu, Eclair and Raspberry, my favorite shades would have to be Eclair, which is this one. I prefer the formulation for the glittery / satin eyeshadow shades on this one, Eclair, as compared to Red Velvet. This is like the perfect like eyeshadow to go for, like a very nice brown shade all over the lids, a bit of mascara, a bit of liner if you'd like, and you're good to go. So overall, I'm impressed with the Ferrero Rocher Beauty eyeshadows. I wouldn't say very impressed because there are some like parts of the eyeshadows that I don't really like, but they perform pretty well to me. And yeah, I would recommend them to you guys if you have the budget and if you are really a big eyeshadow junkie and you want some Ferrero Rocher Beauty eyeshadows in your collection. Alright you guys, so we've come to the end of my video today. I hope you guys enjoyed it and found it helpful. As always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it and if you did find it helpful. And do subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this and more videos from me. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me and thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon in my next video. Bye!